Hello, and as you can see, I have a new setup for my camera. I bought some brackets to put my camera over that side. Just gives me a bit more freedom, I think, and I don't keep elbowing you. Although, I've got to be careful I don't shake the table too much. So we'll see how this works. I also think it's going to add a bit more work to my editing, because I think I'm going to have to flip the image, aren't I? Yeah. But that's okay. That's easy enough. I know how to do that in the program, I think. Excuse me while I peel the dried paint from my spatula. So we're doing the Mission Inspiration for September. Oh wow, September already. Can't believe it. So, I'm going to start with the Add Paint with Spatula or Flat Edge. I'm going to use the suggested grey, which I have to mix up because I don't have the grey ready made. Quite a bit of white. Little bit of black. And mix that up. Bit more black. Yep. Probably want it a little bit darker. Just a little bit, so I'm going to put some black again to the side. Oops, see, too much. Gotta put it to the side. Black is a very strong colour, obviously, so when you do mix up grey, you only need a little bit. I think it's a bit more. Ooh, teensy bit more. I'm trying to match the grey that's in the colour scheme. Okay, I think that will do. Right. I've already got a few of those. Can I put that there? I can. Okay, so this way. And then I think I want to go for is of gold. Let's see if that's gonna be rusty enough. I think that's rusty enough for me. I'm just gonna start. Yeah, that's perfect. Now, do I want to do the verdigris now or add that later? I think we'll incorporate that later. Let's just go for the two colours to begin with. Now, I'm going to pop that to one side for a moment and grab my image wherever I put her. Oh dear, I mean, put her away. Oh, she's here. I put her away with the rest of the magazine bits. So let's move this out of the way now. Now, I think I do want to just tear her. Now, let's see. Okay, so I'm just going to give this a quick blast to dry it off. I'll come back when that's done. There we go, that didn't take long at all because the paint is so thin. So now we're going to adhere our girl. And I'm going to use this opportunity to get some clear gesso down on the page. So, let's see how it's drying off. It's a bit wet still, so. Use the big brush. Mm. Paige with Tesso. And then I will coat the back of my image. Pop her down on the edge. And then go over the top. That bit, and then I'm going to go into this bit. This is a very, very gritty gesso, so that's going to add a lot of tooth to the page. And hopefully, when I do a later step, going to provide a good ground for what I want to do. It's not going to soak in too quickly to the page. Right. Next step. So, I've got a torn magazine image that is also my focal point. Add texture paste, coloured. Make marks in your paint or paste. How am I going to do that? How am I going to do that? So, let me mix up some fiber paste with some gold medium. Not gold medium, some of that paint again, the rust colour. Here we go. Some clean spatula or cleanish. Drops of this. It's quite a wet fluid medium, that one, so I don't want to put too much on. interesting colour. Never mind, there we go. How am I going to make marks into it? What am I going to do? May have to just use some circles. So, yes, the gesso is still wet, but that doesn't matter. Try and get rid of some of the that we don't want on the image. So if we're going to be making marks, we're going to need it fairly thick. So let's grab, where is that little thing on the bob? It might be in the mark making box, which is somewhere down here. Excuse me while I'm looking through my junk. Oh, hi, there it is. Excuse me. Yep, like that. Oh, slipped. Some smaller rocks. Okay. Okay, so now I need that to dry. And I'll have a look at the prompts again and see what is next. Okay, so next step I'm going to do is the drips or splashes of water. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this Lucky Clover Distress Ink. Hear that gesso, the tooth on it. There we go, and that's what's going on the face as well, and get that right. There we go, and now I'm going to just some water on there, and then blah. There we go. Very nice. And then I'm just going to heat that and dry it off. Just got rid of any excess water. My battery's flashing. So I need to find my spare. Let's see what the next step is. Okay, so I think the last two things are industrial or mechanical elements and quote ovaries. So I think I need to find some cogs and bits, and I will be back. Okay, so I'm going to use my stamps and some embossing powder. And we'll see if these stamps actually want to stick to the block. Right. Let's see then. Well, that's interesting. Okay, so let's just brush it all off. not quite sure what happened there. So let's just try giving that a quick heat. Dry it off again. Okay. Let it cool down a second. Okay, so that is not going to work. It's just sticking everywhere. So let's just push it all off again. Let's just try it this way. Okay, so far so good. So I'm going to repeat that a few times. So we've got a few cogs. So now I'm gonna just tear these up a bit. Where we want them on the page. Put these on because we've got distress ink on there which will move. So I'm going to grab a little brush. And then we will go onto the back of the tissue paper. And gently over the top. Now, let's get out the label maker. I think I want a white one this time. Got black, white, and white with black ink, yep. Bold. So it's going to be quite a long coat, I think. Yeah. Now then. Okay, so I'll just snipped off some lunch there. So, that's this side. Now, okay. TV downstairs, it's a bit loud. I'm hoping you can't hear it. I might just try and get rid of the background noise. Is that everything? Is it finished? Splashes? Yeah, I think I'm going to add some splashes today. Is that paint still wet there? It is, okay. So let's grab the water. Get a bit of water there. Grab my brush. Gone a bit hard, I need to give it a good wash. Okay. Just move the tablet. Okay. think that is that finished now. So, I hope you enjoyed that. And I'll put a link to Mike's group down below for Mission Inspiration so you can come and join the fun. And I hope to see you all again soon. Bye guys.